three. So, if we have a look at the Reynolds stress tensor of the jet, in particular in a self-similar form, it looks actually relatively easy to model. But that's only half of the picture. And this is where I want to go back now to the picture of the movie that I showed in the beginning from the University of Denmark. Have a look at this jet over here. So if you have a look at the turbulence that you see there, in particular when you're looking close to the nozzle, you can see these sort of mushroom-shaped vortices that are being generated. And these vortices are going to be quite of different than what you're seeing further downstream, where you see that these larger vortices that are being generated very close to the nozzle, they're starting to break up and then becoming rather incoherent, broken up, smaller scale turbulence further downstream. So, in the beginning, you have these coherent structures that are going to be determining the turbulence in your flow. And this is essentially the concept of coherent structures in turbulence, that you need to take care of these coherent structures. These coherent structures are highly inhomogeneous, and they are dominating the flow field, and they are approximately the same size of your geometry. So they are in the order of magnitude of your diameter of your jet here, for example. So the concept of coherent structures was more or less established somewhere in the 70s. So you can see here a picture of a famous study that was a study of a mixing layer. That means you're not having a jet, you're just looking at the mixing layer between two streams. That means one stream is a bit faster than the other, and see how the two mix. And what they found here in this picture is that there are actually large coherent structures present. And since then, this is since this study from Brown and Roscoe, which was in 1974, there have been many studies on turbulent structures and coherent structures in general. There's one mathematical explanation or one definition that been brought up, and that is from Hussein. He brought a mathematical description of a coherent structures as a coherent structure as a connected large-scale turbulent fluid mass with phase-correlated vorticity or spatial content. So, but this is more or less, let's say, a mathematical or a physical definition of it. It's generally more what you can see that in a transient flow, if you're having a look at the transient turbulent flow, where you can see these large structures. So in particular, I want to show you here a simulation from a mixing layer. And what you can see is the scalar transport. That means you're still having a mixing layer. That means a lower flow over here is going to be twice as fast as the upper one. And you can see there are some sort of turbulent structures that are being developed. And in particular, when you're producing some sort of oscillation. So here's going to be some perturbation that's being introduced into the flow. At the lid of where the mixing takes place, it's just a small perturbation, and that is going to trigger now this Kelvin-Helmholtz instabilities, and these are producing these large-scale structures. They are very interesting to see, and then these are essentially dominating now the flow field. So, and if you want to model turbulence, if you want to model a jet, these are the ones that are going to be the most difficult to adapt.